Delay. The judge said no. How do you react to that?
First of all, we acknowledge that the judge saw a problem, which is the fact that she adjourned this case forward and not basically putting us in a position to present testimony today shows that the judge understood that this investigation has been compromised. And it has been compromised and was still being compromised by a private law firm that is still representing Mr. Snyder. I think that today's decision was a good decision. We are going to take every single day and take it as is. And after the 30-day adjournment, we'll come back and we'll update the court. And the court said that she would be willing to entertain, whether it's a motion or whatnot. We don't know what's going to happen. What we know is this. We have identified a flaw in the process that happened over 3 years ago. We know that the citizens of Flint deserve a thorough investigation to hold those that caused the Flint water crisis accountable. We know that that's been compromised from the onset. As you heard today, there is still a lot of potential evidence that is out there. We are talking about over 20 million documents that were identified as related to the Flint water problem over 3 years ago. After the governor's office's law firm vetted that information and directed the discovery process, we only received 1.5 million pages. That is of grave concern to the prosecution, and we believe that we have to do our due diligence. We'll continue to do that to make sure that our investigation is going through. For a full investigation, we need to be privy of all information. And I think that the people of Flint deserve that, and I think that the citizens of Michigan deserve that. Until today, they have not received that, and we are here to change that process.
Is